Are you running a Go program that needs to be compiled differently depending on which machine it's running on? Hi, my name's Swani. In this tutorial, we're going to cover two common techniques to conditionally compile our Go code depending on which machine we're building it for. So we'll start by creating a new Go project. I'm going to use Go mod init and call this tutorial/cc tutorial. And then we're going to create ourselves a main.go file. Here's the package name main because we want it to be runnable. And next we're going to put in a main function here for our executable's entry point. And I'm going to call a function called printmyOS for print my operating system. What we're going to do is we're going to conditionally compile this function depending on which operating system we're running on. We'll start by creating a file called printer-darwin.go. And we'll give it the package name main again. And here we're going to define a function called printmyOS. And inside we'll use the format.println. And we're going to say, hello, this is Darwin. And we can save this. And if we go to the terminal, what we're going to do next is copy this file into another file called printer_linux.go. And if we open up printer-linux.go, then inside here we're going to change this from saying hello this is Darwin to hello this is Linux. Now hopefully you've kind of caught on that the printer go file that's going to be compiled will match to whatever operating system we're currently running on. So if I go into the terminal and I call go run here, it's going to print hello this is Darwin because I'm running this on a MacBook. However, if I go over to say my Raspberry Pi and I run the same code, so if I go run here, it prints out hello this is Linux. So what's actually happening here is that the Go compiler is picking up on the suffix of the Go files and determining which one it's going to compile depending on the operating system that you're currently running. We can actually take this a step further and not only define which operating system we're running on, but also the architecture of the chipset as well. So to do this, we're going to firstly copy our printer-darwin.go file, and we'll copy it into a new file called printer-mac, and we'll call this m1.go. And then we'll also rename the printer-darwin.go file to printer-mac-intel. Basically, we're going to want to be able to tell the compiler somehow, compile this one when the chipset's in Intel, and then compile this other file when the chipset is a ARM M1. So let's start in the Mac Intel. We're going to add something at the top here, which is our build options. Firstly, we need it to build when the operating system is Darwin, and then secondly, we want it to not build when the architecture is ARM64. So we can save this and then jump over and do something similar for the Mac M1 file. So this here should build when the operating system is Darwin, but also when the chipset is an ARM64. Finally, we're gonna make this print, hello, this is Darwin, with ARM over here. If we save this, jump into the terminal and run it, then it says, hello, this is Darwin with ARM. And of course, we can go run this code on an Intel MacBook. And if we call go run from the terminal here, it says, hello, this is Darwin, because we're not meeting this build constraint of ARM64. Instead, we're meeting this build constraint of it being Darwin, but without ARM64. The last thing that I want to mention about build tags is that you may see two different styles of build tag. So this style that I've shown you is kind of the older style, but there's another one which looks like this, go build. And what's cool about this is that you can use conditional logic here. So you can say Darwin and ARM64 instead. Both are legitimate build tags to be using on Go 1.17 or higher. You are likely to see both kinds of build tags as you go through various code bases. However, the more modern Go colon build tag is usually preferred because it's a bit more expressive and less error prone. I hope that this video has helped you solve whatever cross-compilation puzzle you're currently working on. I've been Juani Bryson, and I'll see you later.